Hi all, welcome to mechanical engineering classes. In today's class, we will discuss about two gauges for finding low vacuum pressure and ultra high vacuum pressure. Okay, so the two gauges are thermal conductivity gauge and ionization gauge. In first one, again there are two types, Pirani gauge and thermocouple type gauge. Okay, here what is the use of this low vacuum pressure and ultra high vacuum, where we are creating this atmosphere? So now necessity of this low vacuum is we are creating this vacuum pressure in the coating industries, metallic coatings and metallic or alloy surfaces. So this environment we are creating. For ultra high vacuum pressure means it is 10 power minus 7 newton per meter square. Okay, in thermal conductivity word, what is the meaning of thermal conductivity? Here thermal means heat, conductivity means if any object is passing heat through it, it is called, it has some thermal conductivity. Okay, and similarly I give example here, a object we are taking, we are giving some q amount of heat. Okay, it is taking some q1 heat, let us assume like that. I am taking the second object, okay, b object, I am giving the same amount of Q to it. It is absorbing Q2 amount of heat. Okay. If we measure Q1 and Q2, let us assume Q1 is greater than Q2. What is the meaning of this? A object is taking more heat compared to the B object. We can say A object has more thermal conductivity than B object. Okay, this is the example of thermal conductivity. Okay, both A and B has thermal conductivity because both are taking the or passing the heat through it. In this case, A has more thermal conductivity than B. Similarly, we are taking electrical conductivity. Okay, so electrical conductivity means the material which is allowing the electrical current through it. It is called electrical conductivity. Okay. It is passing the electricity through it. We can call this material or this conductor or this cable has electrical conductivity. Here also I am taking two examples, wire A I am taking and similarly wire B I am taking here, two wires I am taking. I am giving input is here I, here also I am giving. Okay. Because of some resistance, let us assume, it is taking I1 amount of current. Now it is taking, because of some resistance, every object, every cable has, every conductor also we can call, every conductor has some resistance. Because of resistance in the B cable, it is taking I2 current. If we measure I1, I2, let us assume I2 is more than I1. The I2 current is more, it is taking more current compared to A cable. So we can call it as B is passing more current. B has more electrical conductivity than A. Okay, so it has more electrical conductivity. So this conductivity is the property of the material which is allowing here heat, it is called thermal conductivity, which is allowing current, it is called electrical conductivity. This conductivity we are using in the gauges for finding the pressure value. Okay, so here if you see what is the working principle of this thermal conductivity gauges means? Let us see here, working principle. Now here we are taking the working principle of this gauges is the thermal conductivity will find the pressure value of the given medium. Now let us see how this working principle we can explain. I took here three cases working principle. So in the first case, case one, I am taking the medium, whatever atmosphere around this cable, this is the electrical wire. Why I am taking wire means in Pirani gauges, we are taking the electrical circuit. That's why I am giving the example of this. I am taking the surrounding surface is, okay, it has atmosphere. The medium is atmospheric air. Okay. And here I am taking one cable. We can call this as the conductor also. Conductor means which is passing the electricity through it. Okay, it has some resistance. If for some time, okay, some t time, if I or current is passing through it, some heat will generate in this cable, okay, Q. So what is the formula for Q? We can take I square RT. This amount of heat is generating from the cable. Okay. I means here electrical current, flow of electrons. R means resistance of the cable. Time, T is time, how much time we are sending the electricity. So this heat is coming here. This heat will dissipate in the atmospheric air. Obviously, whatever heat is coming, it is going to the atmosphere. Okay. Now, in the next case, second case, I am taking the medium around this cable. Okay. I am taking the medium around this cable is cool temperature. Means cool air I am taking here. We can define this medium as either it has higher pressure. If you are taking cooled temperature air, it has higher pressure medium, or higher density medium, or higher conductivity medium. Okay, we can define this medium in terms of three, either this or this or this. Why I am taking higher density means water, cool air we are taking here, because of this cool medium, it has some water particles in it, in the air. Okay, so because of that, it has high density, high mass of the particles. Because of that, we are calling higher density medium. Okay, because of it, it has higher pressure also. Okay, on this conductor, or we can call higher conductivity also. Okay, now in this medium, I am passing for the same cable, same amount of current I am giving here to the cable, with R is the resistance of this wire. Okay, in it also Q is generate, some heat will generate. This heat is immediately going into this atmosphere because it is already cool. Okay, so because of that, temperature of this cable is reducing immediately. Now, as we know, temperature is proportional to resistance of this cable. If temperature is immediately getting low, the resistance of the cable is getting less. Okay, because it has low resistance. Okay, so here what I am trying to say is, whatever conductivity, higher conductivity medium is changing the resistance of this cable. Okay, so the conductivity we are using this property we are using for measuring the R value, okay, resistance value. This change in R will find the pressure value, okay, of this medium. So that is the working principle here. In next case, I am taking hot gases around this cable. Okay, here I am taking the same cable. The medium is hot gases, let us assume. Okay, hot gases means those gases are very light in weight. We can call it as lower density medium or lower pressure, because hot gas is going upward direction. Okay, so because of that, we can say it has lower density. We can call that medium lower conductivity. Now I am taking this lower density or lower conductivity medium. I am supplying high amount of current, or is the resistance of this cable. In it also, some heat will generate. This heat, already here we are giving the hot gas or lower density or lower conductivity medium. It will not take this heat immediately, because already this medium is very hot particles. Okay, high temperature medium it has. Okay, so because of that, temperature of this cable will increase instead of decrease. Because of surrounding hot gases, this temperature will increase. Okay, because already it has heat. Because of the heat particles, this temperature will increase. So this, as we know, T is proportional to R. So resistance of the cable will increase. Here this medium is increasing the resistance of this cable. This resistance will find the change in resistance will find the pressure value of this medium. Okay, that is a working principle. Here temperature of the cable is increasing. Here temperature of the cable is decreasing. So the conductivity is changing the temperature or resistance of the cable. Okay, so this is a working principle. Change in the conductivity of the medium will change the resistance of the cable. That change in resistance will find the pressure of the medium. Okay, before explaining Pirani gauge, first I will explain what is Wheatstone bridge. Because in Pirani gauge, we are taking this Wheatstone bridge modification form. Okay, so here in Wheatstone bridge, we are taking four cables. It has resistance A for this part, and it has resistance B, and it has resistance C, and it has resistance D. Now we are supplying electricity through this cable or circuit. Here this is the adjustable resistance. Okay, because of it we can get some amount of current here. I has some value. Okay, so it will give the some current value. This is called galvanometer. Now here adjust the bridge. This is the adjustment. Okay, so that I value here is zero by changing this resistance, adjustable resistance. Keep the I value is zero here. Okay, previously it has some other value, but by changing this value we can keep I is zero. Okay, this position is called null position. It is giving zero current here. It is called null position. At this null position, we can write this formula. Okay, A by B means resistance of A divided by resistance of B is equal to resistance of C divided by resistance of D. okay, because this bridge is symmetrical about this line, so we can write A by B is equal to C by D. By using this bridge, if we don't know this D value, okay, we have to find this D value. So by that resistance we have to connect here, okay, we need to find D here. So here we have to supply the current, okay, it is showing some current value, and adjust this resistance so that I should be zero. At that time, take this formula, A by B is equal to whatever B value we are giving here, that B value, and C, A and C are known values, A and C are, D is unknown, okay. From this we can find D is equal to, here C is as it is, into this part will come here, B by A. So like this we can find any resistance unknown value by using this balanced bridge or Wheatstone bridge at null position. Okay, here in Pirani gauges also we are using the same bridge. We are changing the one of the medium of the resistance. Let us see how it is working. Here see the description of Pirani gauge. This is also a Wheatstone bridge with four filaments of resistance A. Here adjustable resistance B. Here one resistance C. Here one resistance D. Normally in this Pirani gauge we are using platinum filaments. Okay. Now here inside this gauge, how much current is passing we can find by using galvanometer. We have to connect galvanometer here. This is a symmetrical bridge. Okay. And now power supply we have to give to this bridge here like this. Okay. And here one chamber is there. So here we have to supply the gas which we want to find the pressure value, applied pressure. How much this pressure? So by using this Pirani gauge we can find the P value. This is the description of this gauge. Now see the operation of this Pirani gauge. Here initially I am not sending this gas in this chamber. Okay. So whatever atmosphere here, the same atmosphere here, we have to adjust this B link so that G value should be zero. It is called null position. We have to keep this bridge initially in null position. Null position means whatever resistance this side A by B ratio of resistance is equal to ratio of resistance C by D. Okay, at null position. First we have to keep the bridge in null position. Now after that, in second step also, we have to give the power supply to this Wheatstone bridge. One new thing is here we have to connect the chamber around this platinum filament. So here we have to supply the gas of unknown pressure. This pressure we have to find by using this bridge. Okay. So here we have to supply the gas. Because of that gas, this resistance will change. A resistance will change. This is previously it is balanced bridge. It was showing zero. Because change in resistance will unbalance the bridge, it is giving instead of zero some other value. Okay. So for balancing this bridge, for keeping I is zero, we have to adjust this B value. Resistance, we have to adjust this resistance so that I should be zero or null position. So we don't know how much A resistance value. By using this formula, we can find A. Okay, resistance of this filament. So here this calibrated resistance will give the P value, how much pressure of the gas we are applying here. Okay, this is the main working of this Pirani gauge. Now in this case, I am telling, previously I took two cases. If we are sending higher conductivity gas, how the pressure is. If we are sending lower conductivity gas, how the pressure is. Okay, previously we took, if we are sending higher pressure gas, okay, resistance will be very less. Okay, resistance is very less if you are sending the higher pressure gas. If you are sending the lower pressure gas, the resistance will be more. So in this filament, okay, so like this. Now same thing here also. If you are sending higher pressure or higher density or a higher conductivity gas here, whatever resistance value is coming, it is low. Okay, that value is calibrated to finding the pressure. In next case, if you are sending the hot gas or lower pressure gas or lower density or lower conductivity gas, whatever A is coming resistance, it will be high. That resistance will give the pressure value. Calibrated scale will be there. At each resistance, we can find the P value. R1, R2, R3, R4, values will be there, R values. It is calibrated scale. If R is some value, okay, 10 ohms, what is the P value? Here P scale will be there. So this is a calibrated scale. We can find the P value by using the change in resistance of the medium. This is the main working operation of the Pirani gauge for finding the P value. Application of this Pirani gauge is to measure low vacuum and ultra high vacuum pressure. Okay, low vacuum is it is less than zero pressure, and ultra high vacuum is it is 10⁻⁷. Okay, the value of P is at ultra high vacuum, so it can measure by using this gauge. Okay, Newton per meter square. Now what are the advantages of this bridge means? They are very simple circuit, so it is less expensive, very accurate results it will give, and good response. Whatever we are changing, immediately we can see the change here, so it will give the good response. And the relation between T and R is linear, means if temperature of the filament is more, resistance will be more, like that. So it is easy to find out the temperature as well as resistance. Here one more advantage, good advantage is we can supply this gas from a long distance also. We can keep this entire bridge in one room, we can supply the gas from the another room. Okay, we can see the we can keep this supply of the gas from a long distance. So these are the advantages. And limitations are it requires electricity. It is a main limitation for different gases. Next one, for different gases we have to take the different calibrated scale. Okay, we can take it is calibrated scale. If you are supplying some nitrogen gas, it has one different calibrated scale. If you are supplying carbon dioxide, it has another scale like that. So they must be calibrated for different gases. And now we have to check during the operation, continuously we have to check. So supply is there or not, and this value is zero, is there or not, like that. Continuous checking should be there. So these are the limitations of this gauges. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel for more updates. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग।